हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम कवरिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। इन दिस करंट वीडियो आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द प्री ऑर्डर बाइनरी ट्री ट्रैवर्सल एंड इट्स रिकर्सिव अल्गोरिदम विद द हेल्प ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the tree traversal techniques. As all of you are knowing, tree is a non-linear data structure. As if any non-linear data structure is there, the non-linear data structure can be traversed in two different ways. They are DFS and BFS. DFS stands for depth first search traversal and BFS stands for breadth first search traversals. DFS, which goes into depth. Depth first traversal, name itself suggests that it goes into depth and then traverse all the nodes which are present in the tree data structure. There are three sub types or the ways or the techniques with which we can traverse the tree with the help of DFS technique. They are pre-order, in-order and post-order traversals. These three different types are based on the position of root node. Here, pre-order is nothing but where the root node is located before the left and right child, then it is called as pre-order. In-order, it means the root node is located in between of the left and right child, and post-order is nothing but the root node is located after or post the left and right child. So, in this way, we can traverse the tree in the either of the order. The another technique is breadth first traversal, where it traverses with the help of level. So, it is also called as level order traversal. The level of the tree, all of you are knowing the level concept. So, according to level, the tree will get traversed with the breadth first traversal technique. To know details about all these different traversals, I am providing you a shortcut link in this right up corner. You can go through that to know the details about all these traversal techniques. Now, in this current video session, I am focusing on binary tree traversals and mainly on the pre-order, where pre-order is nothing but root node, left and right. The same sequence we used to follow for pre-order traversal. Here in this slide, I am again reminding you the sequence which we supposed to follow to traverse any of the tree in pre-order traversal. They are root node. Here you can see that we will start with the root node. Then we need to go to the left subtree or a left child of the root node, and after that we will move forward to the right subtree or a right node, right child. Here in this slide, I am going to explain you the recursive algorithm for the same, that is for pre-order traversal. Now keep in mind, I am explaining you the recursive algorithm with the help of C language. Here I am explaining you the concept as well. After getting the concept, you can implement this algorithm in any of the language with which you are comfortable. So now let's start with the algorithm. Here I have written the function pre-order, where I am passing the parameter root of the tree to the function. This algorithm is divided into three simple steps. This algorithm is recursive algorithm, that's why only three steps are sufficient to execute this algorithm. Here you need to keep in mind that the order which you are going to traverse is nothing but pre-order, where you are going to traverse the root node first, then you are going to move to the left subtree and then to the right subtree. The same order we are supposed to follow in this algorithm, where the step one will be to process the root node. Processing of root node is nothing but display the root node or the information part of the root node. The step 2 will be, we will recursively call the preorder function by passing the left child as a root node, because after recursively calling this function, whatever we are going to pass as a parameter to the function is going to become a root node. So what will be our next step? To move to the left subtree. So that's why in the step 2 we supposed to pass the left child or the address of left child as a root node to the function preorder. And the step 3 will be same, we are going to call again the function preorder recursively, but here we will pass the parameter as a right child of a root node. So this now right child will be our last step, will become the root node and will execute the steps again recursively. So how will be the execution of this algorithm, that I am going to explain you in detail in the next consecutive slides. This is the slide which I have already explained in the introduction of preorder traversal. You can pause this video, you can go through the steps that we supposed to follow while traversing the tree in preorder traversal. If you are knowing all these steps, then you can go forward. Otherwise, just pause the video for a few seconds and get it know, and then you can continue with the rest of the part of the video. Now let's consider that all of you are knowing these steps, where we need to process first of all the root. After that, we need to go to the left child of the tree. This step you need to continue till the left child is present. After that, move to the right child, and then the same steps you need to follow. Now here I am going to explain you how to traverse the tree in preorder with the help of recursive algorithm. So here simple tree I have taken, where A is a root node, B is a left child of root node A, and C is a right child of root node A. Here I am going to explain you it with the help of example, where just remind the steps. First of all, root, you need to process it, then move to the left child, then process it as a root node, and then move to the right and process it as a root node again. After that, now let's look at the recursive algorithm. Here recursive algorithm, which I have already explained in the previous slide, the same algorithm I have written, and now let's start for the execution. Now here what we need to do, we need to start from the root node. So what is our first step? First step is to process the root node. Here I am displaying, or I am giving you the output of this algorithm in the form of preorder traversal. So processing of root node means I am going to display the root node A first. Now next thing, what we need to do? We need to call the preorder function recursively by passing the parameter as a left child. Now if all of you are knowing the concept of recursive algorithm, internally it uses the implicit stack for the execution. What is implicit stack? Implicit stack is nothing but which is used by system internally to store the current variables or the content of the variables, and then the function call will get happen. So here I am making a stack, or I am providing a stack over here, where before this function call, before going to the step, or before moving to the control to the preorder function again, what was the current root, that was A, will get pushed onto the stack. So A is pushed onto the stack, and then preorder traversal function will get called, where you are going to pass as a left child as a root node. So what is left child? B. B is a left child. So now B is going to become a root node again. After becoming it as a root node, we are going to process the root node. So now let's process the root node, and after that, what will be the next step? The next step is to call a preorder function again by passing the left child of current root node. Which one is the current root node? Current root node is B. This is going to become a root node. What is the left child of B? It is null, because there is no any left child of B is present. So whenever if this preorder is null, then we need to stop, and what it will do? It will return, or it will go to the next line of your algorithm. What is next line of algorithm? Now, whenever it will return back, what it will do? It will take A as the root node again by popping the content of your stack. So here we are going to pop the content of your stack, and now current root node is nothing but A. And for age right child, we are going to pass as a parameter to the function preorder. Now let's pass the right child of the root node A as the parameter, and now C will going to become as a root node after calling this function again. Now this C is going to become a root node. We are going to process it again, and after that we will call the preorder function by passing the left child of the root node, that is C. Is there any left child? Left child is present? No. Then it will go to the right child. Is there any right child present? No. Both are null. So that's why it will not get executed. You supposed to execute this if the root is not equal to null. If root is not equal to null, then and then only you supposed to execute these steps. If root is equal to null, then you are not going to go into the if condition. This steps will not get followed and you need to exit. So in this way the output will be A, B and C will be the pre-order traversal of the given tree. Now let's move forward for the next example. Here in this example we are following the same steps again. Here I am using the stack again to explain the concept of the recursive algorithm, and at the bottom I am displaying the pre-order traversal of the given tree. Now let's start with the root. Whenever you are going to use the root, we supposed to process it first of all, then we will call the pre-order function by passing its left child. Before that we need to push 10 onto the stack. Now 20 will become a root node. After becoming it as a root node, again we will check whether root is not equal to null. It is not equal to null, that's why process the root and 20 will get processed. After that pass the left child of the root node 20. It is null, so that's why whenever we will enter into the function, if the root is not equal to null, this condition will get false and it will go to the next statement, that is for the current root node it is 20, pass its right child. You can see that here right child is present, so now this 30 will become the root node, because current root is 20 and its right child we are going to make it as a root. So now what will happen? Now 30 is going to become a root node, and what is our first step is to process the root node. After processing it, again 30's left child we need to pass as a parameter, as a root node. Before that 30 will get inserted onto the stack, or will get pushed onto the stack, because here we are going to move to the left child of the tree. Now after that what is going to be happen? 30's left child is 50. 50 is going to become a root node. First of all process it, so that's why it will get processed here. After that again left child of 50 will get passed. It is null, so here if condition, if the root is not equal to null, the condition is false, it will not enter into if and it will get exited, and it will go to the next function is nothing but next step is nothing but pre-order right child. What is right child of 50? It is again a null, the condition is false, it will get exited, and it will return back by popping the next item from your stack. So 30 will get popped and then it will go to the 60. 60 will become a root node and it will get display, and after that we will pop 10 as well, because we have done with the right subtree of 20. Now it's turn to go to the right subtree of 40, for which the current root node is 10. We have done with the left subtree and now it's turn for a right subtree. For that the 10's right child we will pass as a parameter, and 40 will become a root node. After that we need to process 40. First of all it is processed, it is displayed over here. Then call the preorder function where 40 is left child is null, the condition is false, it will not enter into the if condition, it will return back and then it will check for a right child, it will pass as a right child, which is also again null, the condition is false and it will return back. At the end you can see that your stack is empty and it means that you have done with the pre-order traversal. This stack will get maintained internally by the system. As a programmer, we don't have any efforts to maintain the stack. It will get maintained automatically by the system. So in this way, you can execute the pre-order traversal where it follows the sequence root node, left child and right child. So thank you friends, I hope you are understanding the concept of pre-order traversal and mainly the recursive algorithm in this current video session. So thank you friends, if you like the content and the video, please like the video, please give the comment, share it with your friends, and here I am providing you the subscription link, please subscribe my channel, and along with that I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, and the whole video series also I am providing in the form of playlist. Thank you. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Thank you.